Okay, let me start with the big picture about financial industry. But maybe on the macro, I think you know that Fed fund rate is not coming down yet. Yeah, Fed fund rate now is about 5.5%. And Indonesia central bank rate is 5.75. So maybe this is the first time in Indonesia history that only different di sini. I saw also Pak Anton Gunawan is another senior economist here. 25 basis point only. Central bank rate and Fed fund rate. Usually perbedaannya about maybe 1.5%. So this is today we able to manage only different 25 basis point. Yeah. Why? First, because our trade balance surplus, because the fiscal situations is very healthy. The fiscal deficit this year target is only 2.3% of GDP. Could be lower than that, yeah, the realizations. Oh. Yeah, but if you look the forecast of international economies, they make forecast that by 2024 Fed fund rate is coming down. So hopefully by that time Indonesia also able to cut rate. Hopefully we able to manage our current accounts, export import goods and services still in the healthy level. Okay, on the financial industry, we look on the in the capital markets. Capital markets in terms of industry, we have mutual funds industry year to date increase a little bit. Year to date is 1.2%. Total mutual fund plus KPD, RDPT, EBA dan sebagainya, total is about 844 trillion rupiah. This is growth 2% year to date. Jumlah investor retail is about 11.5 million people. Compared to 2021, retail investor is at 7.4 million. In terms of value of capital raise, year to date until August 2023, 172 trillion rupiah. Number of IPO 58, right issue 19, efek surat efek utang ada 9 dan lainnya ada 62, total 148. Okay, if you look the banking sectors, this is the largest sector in the in financial industry. So total credit in Indonesia is about 6,700 trillion rupiah. Year on year credit is about 8.5% as of July. Year to date is about 4.1%. Yeah. Actually is slightly lower compared to the when we, I think when everybody economists make forecast at the beginning of the year. because beginning of the year industry or economists forecast the banking sector grew maybe 10-12%. The year on year up to July is 8.5%. Year to date is 4.1%. But the banking sector is very healthy in terms of capital adequacy ratio is 27%, 27.4%. The credit rest through COVID, July is 339 trillion, sudah came down. Last year July was 560 trillion. In terms of non-performing loans gross, last year July was 2.9%. July this year 2.5%. And loan at risk is basically NPL plus special mention loans plus rest-through loans. July last year was 16.8% and July this year is 12.6%. Liquidity is still very ample in the banking sectors. As you probably follow that during the COVID 2020 to 2022, central bank was allowed to buy government bonds in the primary market. So meaning there is a liquidity coming from central bank directly coming to the system. So this helped liquidity a lot in the system. So the asset liquid to total deposit, the liquid asset to total deposit, minimum is 10%. Currently is 26.5%. So liquid asset to total deposit, minimum is 10%. Currently is 26.5%. So liquidity is still very ample in the system, in the banking sectors. I think my fellow economists that follow the monetary or the banking sectors, during the booming, during the tight liquidity, usually the deposit rate was above central bank rate. Pak Fauzi also economist. Yeah, during tight liquidity, during booming era, deposit rate usually above central bank rate, maybe 100 basis point. But now average deposit rate is only about 4.3-4.4%. Central bank rate 5.75%. So if people say only tight liquidity, just look, you look compare central bank rate with the deposit rate on the average. Of course, maybe there are some banks that offering deposit rate above central bank rate, but on average, the deposit rate now is still maybe 200 basis, 150 basis point below central bank rate. Okay, so we coming to the insurance industry. So insurance industry in terms of premium, July cumulative is 177 trillion as of July. Growth negative 2.3%. Insurance premium cumulative July negative 2.3%. Why? Of the 177 trillion, 102 trillion came from life insurance premium. The life insurance premium growth negative 7.8%. Even though the general insurance and reinsurance premium 75 trillion rupiah growth 6.3% positive. So who made, which industry that made the insurance premium negative growth is the life insurance industry. Why? I think a lot of player from insurance industry here. Yeah. I think this is still a story about unit link. About unit link. So OJK in 2022 issued stricter regulation in unit link. OJK Consumer Protections under Bu Kiki also issued stricter regulation in the consumer protection, yeah, including in the market conduct, yeah, also in market conduct, also including for the insurance company, yeah. But we believe, yeah, that the industry learning about this, yeah. So I heard, yeah, several new products issued by the industry. Customer learning, yeah. So we believe that this is just a consolidation period for the life insurance industry. To the better. To the better. Yeah. So don't pessimist. Don't be pessimistic. Because you know, with the insurance to your penetration of insurance in Indonesia is only 2.3% of GDP. Yeah. Compared to Thailand 4.6%, compared to Singapore 12.5%. And the characteristic of developed country, penetration of insurance is much higher than this. Yeah, if you look, Malaysia is 3.8, Thailand is 4.6, and Indonesia half of it. So, meaning still a lot of potential, a lot of potential. Yeah. So the homework is how to have a product that fit with the public, with the customer, how the regulator also to support the development of the industry. So the Undang-Undang P2SK, the Omnibus Law, actually give a new mandate to OJK, to Bank Indonesia, to Ministry of Finance. Kalau sebelumnya mengatur, mengawasi, melindungi. Undang-Undang P2SK menambah add one word tentang mengembangkan. Makanya Pak Adi namanya undang-undangnya kan pengembangan dan penguatannya. Yeah. So I said to my friend at OJK, so don't forget that we have a new mandate, not only to regulate, to supervise, to protect customer, but we have to develop. We have to develop. Yeah. If we look in terms of the healthiness of the insurance industry, we have RBC of 460.3% as of July, way above the minimum. Yeah, way above the minimum. This is for the life insurance, and for the general insurance and reinsurance, the RBC is 311%. Also above the minimum. Yeah. If we look on the literacy and inclusions, banking sectors, inclusions about 74% and literacy 49%. This is the sectors that, this is the largest sectors in Indonesia financial sectors. So I think majority people in Indonesia know already about banking. Yeah. So that's it's not a surprise that the inclusion is 74% and literacy is about 49%. But insurance, literacy is higher than inclusion. Literacy is about 31%. Inclusion for insurance only 16%. Compared to banking sector, inclusion about 74%. And pension fund is even lower. Yeah, so inclusion for pension fund is only 5.4%. Compared to insurance 16% and banking sector 74%. And for so meaning that, yeah, still not only the job of OJK to do the educations. Yeah. So we ask the industry, we work together, the media, yeah, the associations, we have to increase the educations, yeah, to the public, to the society, about insurance and also about pensions. So what is the challenge on this industry, insurance and pensions, including the guarantee? So in OJK, previously, before January 2023, we call it Bidang IKNB. Now, bidangnya Pak Ogi, we call it Bidang PPDP. Another singkatan. Yeah. PPDP itu apa ya, Bu? Perasuransian, penjaminan, dana pensiun. Jadi perspektif konsumen, literasi keuangan terkait manfaat dan risiko produk layanan sektor. Nah, ini hasil dari survei. Konsumen perspektif perlu literasi terkait manfaat dan risiko produk layanan sektor insurance and pension fund. Penerapan prinsip-prinsip perlindungan konsumen. Ya. So maybe for Bapak Ibu yang dari industri atau dari ya para peserta, the status dari komisioner perlindungan konsumen, edukasi dan perlindungan konsumen itu ada berubah. Sebelumnya tidak disebut kepala eksekutif. Undang-undang P2SK itu sekarang menyebut edukasi dan perlindungan konsumen itu menjadi kepala eksekutif. Sama seperti kepala eksekutif perbankan, kepala eksekutif asuransi, kepala eksekutif pembiayaan, kepala eksekutif pasar modal. Artinya perlindungan konsumen itu sekarang menjadi setara. So if Bapak Ibu menawarkan produk. Produk insurance, produk pension funds, product of capital markets, banking product. Don't forget to balance between offering product, the commercial side, and offering product, the consumer protection side. And we are serious about this. Yeah. We are doing the the OJK PPDP tempatnya Pak Ogi itu bikin presentasi judulnya Industrial Reform. Yeah, to send message to the industry that OJK wants to the reform for internal OJK and also to the industry. Industrial reform. Kebutuhan permodalan akan diperkuat. The capital. Quality of governance and risk management. Diperkuat. So if you follow beberapa regulasi yang terbit dan akan terbit dari OJK, ada penguatan governance di banking sector. Penguatan governance di banking sector itu termasuk di bank umum, termasuk juga di BPR. Penguatan governance di capital markets, governance and risk management, di insurance, di pension funds. Nanti menyusul di lembaga pembiayaan, kewajiban sertifikasi, kewajiban sertifikasi, kewajiban ada untuk lakukan pelatihan training untuk internal. Previously, banking sector already done this long time ago. There is a specific percentage of the human resource cost have to go to pelatihan pengembangan pegawai. Nanti ada buat BPR, ada buat insurance, ada buat lembaga pembiayaan. Karena sebelumnya kalau ditanya kenapa enggak lakukan pelatihan, selalu terus kemudian baliknya enggak diatur. Kalau enggak diatur ngapain buat pendidikan? Aneh juga ya, kok perlu harus diatur untuk mendidik karyawannya sendiri. Akhirnya dibuatlah aturannya, semuanya minta diatur. Mohon maaf nih, saya ini emang stylenya begini kalau ngomong. Pemenuhan kebutuhan expert khususnya di bidang aktuaria, ahli investment analysis dan IT. We know about the risk of IT, everybody knows. Cyberware dan sebagainya. Aktuaria sekarang dimonitor pemenuhannya. Tentu termasuk aktuaria untuk internal OJK juga. So tadi kan saya bilang, we do in reform not only to the industry, OJK-nya juga harus doing reform. Investment analysis. Pension fund invest in the capital market. Insurance invest in the capital market. Ya, teman-teman yang di asuransi, yang di insurance harus paham tentang the risk of capital markets. Data terintegrasi di OJK. Sekarang kami perkuat karena mandat OJK adalah terintegrasi. So now the supervisor in the insurance, supervisors in the pensions, they can monitor on the regular basis about investment of the insurance company, of the pension funds, the investment, especially in the capital markets. Yeah. Mutasi internal dilakukan di dalam OJK. Supaya yang mengawasi asuransi tahu capital market, yang mengawasi capital market tahu tentang asuransi. Ya, internal mutasi dilakukan di dalam internal OJK. Alokasi sumber daya pengawasan dan secara efektif dan efisien. Prioritas OJK 5 tahun ke depan terkait bidang ini tentu ya, tadi Bapak lihat ada RBC yang sangat baik, tapi kita tentu tahu masih ada yang sakit. So we have to deal with it. Yeah. Kita harus menyelesaikan. Yeah. 5 years from now we will have penjaminan untuk asuransi. Sebelum penjaminan untuk asuransi itu ada, OJK harus membereskan perusahaan-perusahaan yang saat ini belum sehat. Banyak aturan-aturan turunan dari P2SK yang harus dibuat tahun 2023-2024. Dan tadi ya, salah satu that's already mentioned by Bu Nelly dan tadi oleh Pak Sua, that terkait PSAK, IFRS yang sekarang sudah ada task force-nya, ya, penyiapan bahwa industri implementasi of this IFRS dan PSAK ini harus bisa terlaksana dengan baik.